Hello, everyone. It is time for a brand new round of box office predictions. It feels kind of weird that this is the first post-marathon round of box office predictions. I'm surprised I was able to get up the stairs right now to the set, but slowly improving. It was a great race day. If you're part of the Patreon campaign, I'm working on an extra special video this weekend that I can't wait to share with you guys because it just chronicles what the whole day was like, which was an absolute dream. Can't wait to tell you more about it. Let's get into some recapping from last weekend, specifically right now with Fantasy Movie League, where we had 10 perfect lineups. You see all the names up on the screen right now. Guyette, Chilcat's Laboratory, The Black Knight, Devil, Joey at Vizrec, Doom's Movie Dome, Farmer Boy, Bunda Cineplex, Angry Geek, Mazul 0600 Cineplex, and The Force Aid Nathans. Congratulations, guys. Job very well done. I feel like we've got the season semi-winding down right now, which is why I'm very happy that last weekend I wound up in 45th place, and overall I'm at like 30 right now, which, hey, I'm feeling pretty good about it. My goal is always to be in the top 100, but if I could be in the top 50 this time around, yes. Now, recapping the top five from last weekend, I wound up going 3 for 5. The one that I'm most bummed about, though, is obviously the big swing and miss I took on Terminator Dark Fate. My prediction was actually already under expectations, but it still wasn't even low enough. The movie opened with a mere $29 million. Number two was Joker, which enjoyed yet another super strong hold, a mere 30% dip for another $13.5 million. Then at number three, it was Maleficent, Mistress of Evil, which held better than I expected and earned another $13.1 million. Then at number four, it was actually Harriet, which had a solid opening with a $5,671 per theater average. Its $11.7 million opening haul was more than enough to top the Addams Family, which came in at number five with $8.3 million. All right, moving into the new top five right now and kicking it off, of course, with the number five position. I was debating with this one between Joker and also the new release, Playing with Fire. And eventually I had to ask myself, do you go with the wild card of a new release that could go any which way? Or do you just go with Joker, which has proved time and time again, it's got immense staying power? And the answer is obvious. My number five pick this time around is Joker. After this movie's performance the last 2 weeks, I am not bringing up the percent change beyond 35%, especially considering the fact that none of the new big releases are really making much of a splash at the box office. Plus, this movie still has awards buzz. So until we get another major juggernaut of a release, I'm not bringing that percent change up. I'm keeping it right there at 35%. And if Joker loses that this time around, it's still making another $9 million this weekend. Moving on to number four now, that's where I have one of our new wide releases for the weekend. It's the movie Midway. So this one is a little bit of a challenge to place, and I was actually having a similar problem with Playing with Fire. I just don't really know what to make of it. It feels like the marketing campaign hasn't made much of an impression, but looking at that reported $100 million production budget and the fact that Roland Emmerich is the director behind the movie, I have a feeling the folks involved were looking for a big box office smash with this, and that's just not happening. The projections right now come in with about $15 million for this movie's opening weekend, but I, for one, think that's kind of wishful thinking. I think that Midway could wind up being the movie Allied all over again. That one was a Robert Zemeckis movie, and it had a production budget of $85 million. It had big name talent attached, and when it opened up right around this time of year, back in 2016, it made a mere $12.7 million opening weekend, and I kind of think that Midway is going to land in a very similar position. So that is where I'm putting Midway right now, at number four with a $12.5 million opening weekend. All right, now it is time for an unplanned litter robot promo because I'm not capable of walking back down the stairs and up to shut it off and continue this video. So that buzz in the background you're hearing right now is Dewey's good old litter robot, which honestly has been one of the best purchases I've ever made. But anyway, on to the number three spot. That is where I have Terminator Dark Fate. Initially, I was very, very concerned about this one, especially after that really kind of abysmal opening weekend total it made last weekend. I thought it might have been on the same path as something like Gemini Man and heading towards a very, very big Weekend 2 drop, but I kind of veered away from that. I think things are trending in a semi-positive direction with this one, maybe because there's some positive buzz, but it doesn't seem like it's heading towards that 60% drop that Gemini Man saw in its second weekend in theaters, but we still are going to have a substantial drop here. So I'm going to bring it down to just 55%. Thanks for that, Dewey. And if that's what this movie winds up losing in its second weekend of release, it still could make another $13 million. All right, now that brings us to the number two spot, and I'm giving this one to a new release as well. This is where I have the movie Last Christmas. We all well know the second Halloween comes and goes, everybody gets into the holiday spirit, and that's what this movie is all about, especially based on the positive word of mouth I'm hearing. It seems like people really enjoyed it, and it's just the perfect time of year to drop something like this. Excellent counter programming with this one. I've seen projections in the mid-teens, but I think it's actually going to go higher than that. I think of all the new releases we're getting this weekend, this is the one that has the best shot of exceeding expectations, and I actually think it could come pretty close to the Disney release from last year, The Nutcracker and the Four Realms. I know that was a major studio release, and this one might not be as big, but I still think that that movie, which opened up with something like $20 million, is a very realistic possibility for this one right here, particularly because I got a feeling a lot of people out there are in the mood for this kind of movie. So I am going on the very high end with Last Christmas, and I'm going to give it a $20 million opening weekend. All right, that brings us to the top of my list for the week. And this number one spot this time around has to go to Dr. Sleep. Admittedly, with this one, I am a little concerned. I am a little concerned because we've had a whole bunch of big releases come out lately that are underperforming. So that has me worried. But then I remember all the assets this movie has. It is another Stephen King adaptation. It stars Ewan McGregor. It's from the director of The Haunting of Hill House. We didn't really get any good Halloween movies the past couple of weeks, so this fills that void. Plus, it's a good movie, and I'm keeping my fingers crossed that good word of mouth gives this one a little bit of a boost, but I can't get my expectations too high with it, especially because it didn't really open super strongly overseas. So I'm looking at Pet Sematary right now, one of our other Stephen King adaptations from this calendar year. That movie, when it opened up back in April, it made $24.5 million, and I would just be really shocked if Dr. Sleep didn't top that. I don't think I'm confident enough to give it the $30 million mark, which is at the top end of the expectations right now, but I do think that $27 million could be a possibility with this one, so that is what I'm going with for Dr. Sleep, a $27 million opening weekend. That brings us to our recap. Now let's bring up the chart on the screen, and we're kicking it off with number one, Dr. Sleep with $27 million. Then I've got Last Christmas at number two with $20 million. Terminator Dark Fate holding on to that number three spot with $13 million. Then Midway right behind, opening up with $12.5 million. And then Joker hanging on right in that top five yet again with another $9 million. And if you're curious with what I'm guessing for Playing with Fire, I'm thinking like maybe $8 million for that one. That right there, though, is my top five. You know what to do. Now set those Fantasy Movie League lineups and then hit the comment section below. Put your top five picks right there. Very curious to know what you guys think Dr. Sleep is going to do this weekend. And also, when you see the movie, please tell me what you think about it. That's one that you know I'm super hyped about. So I just want to talk to you guys about it. So tell me what you think of the movie when you see it as well. Before I say goodbye, this right here is a very, very special Patreon shout out. I say it all the time, but wait for it on this one because this is going to one of the most important people in my life. It's my mom, Mom and Ems. My mom has really been a Patreon supporter since day one of the campaign, but her support on Patreon is only the tiniest fraction of the love and support she's shown me since day one of me pursuing my career and my passions and just anything else over the course of my life I ever wanted to achieve. Nobody has been more supportive than my mom, and it also feels really important to give my mom another shout out right now because she really made race day on Marathon Day so special. So Mom, I love you so much. Thanks for always being there for me and for supporting all this crazy stuff that I do. You're the best and I love you. And another big thank you to everybody out there watching this video right now. I appreciate your support too. Please like and share this video, and I'll see you next week with more box office predictions.